Have you ever faced the dreaded gamma shift? If so, stick around because you may be getting this setting wrong.
Data levels, full versus video.
Before we get into the video, I'd like to caveat that our topic is not referring to the known QuickTime gamma shift on Mac devices and the Rec. 709A workaround.
What we're going to be talking about is the data level setting that you may have come across in your deliver page, in the video monitoring section of your project settings, and in the media pool under clip attributes.
If you set this wrong anywhere in your pipeline, you most certainly are going to encounter a mismatch. And so that's why it's really important that you understand this. So without further ado, let's dive in.
What is the difference between full and video data levels? Put simply, this refers to the range of brightness values within an image. In full data levels, the range on an 8-bit scale starts from 0, being pure black, and it goes up to 255, which is pure white. On a 10-bit scale, the values are from 0 to 1023. In video data levels, that range is restricted from 16, representing pure black, to 235, being pure white, on an 8-bit scale. In 10-bit, those values are 64 to 940. And to add further confusion, full levels are also referred to as data levels, and video levels are also called legal. So why does this matter, and which one should you choose?
Well, a lot of the confusion comes from the initial instinct to go with full, because of course, why wouldn't you want to work in the full range you have? It makes sense, doesn't it? But you'd be wrong to select full for most of the projects you do, and here is why.
For online and broadcast delivery, the correct data levels are video or legal. And for HDR content for streaming platforms or for cinema deliverables, typically the correct data levels are full or data. But as a general rule of thumb, what you want to do in your deliver page is to simply leave this setting to auto. And the reason is that DaVinci Resolve understands how to set your levels correctly based on the color space, gamma, and codec you choose.
With this in mind, you also want to make sure that your reference display is set correctly to video or full, depending on the project you're working on. And just to clarify, a reference monitor isn't the same as a standard computer monitor.
It is a dedicated color grading monitor that is connected to your device via a capture and playback card. If you're using a laptop or a Mac, this would be any of the items from Blackmagic's Ultra Studio lineup, and if you're working on a workstation or a server, the equivalent would be their DeckLink product. So how can you check what the data levels of your reference display are? Firstly, you can check in your monitor's menu whether there is an option to switch between full and video levels. For example, on ASO monitors, this option is available in the menu under Signal Input Range.
But if you're not seeing this option on your screen, there is another way you can find out what yours is set to by using a calibration image.
Go to Light Illusions' General Downloads, and the image we're going to need is shown at this very page. To download it, alongside 21 additional calibration images, you need to go through a payment of £10. This fee is going to give you one-time only access to all of their downloads, including their LUTs. So make sure you download everything you need by selecting the relevant items on the list before closing the page. Once you've downloaded the calibration images, import them into DaVinci Resolve. Make sure that in your project settings under video monitoring, you've set the data levels accordingly. Since my reference monitor is set to video data levels and this is what it expects, I'll make sure that this is correctly reflected here and Resolve is indeed sending out a video signal. Next, I'm going to import this image into a new timeline. Now, when I look at my reference monitor, I can visually see that the first square is pure black, the second one is pure white, the third is middle grey, and the colour behind them is a very dark shade of grey.
Right. Rather than just relying on your eyes, you can also make sure that each patch is displayed correctly on your screen by taking readings with a colorimeter such as the X-Rite I1 Display Pro. In this scenario, everything works and looks as expected. But if this is not the case for you, here's how you can find out there is a mismatch between the signal that Resolve is sending out and the signal that your reference display is actually expecting.
If the data levels you're sending out from Resolve are full, but your reference display is set to video levels, then what your display does is it incorrectly maps the black and white levels and the overall contrast. So the values between 0 to 16, hence the blacks, and those between 235 and 255, the whites, get clipped. And the visual result you're going to see on the calibration image is much more contrasty. The grey background behind the patches now fully blends in with the first black patch, and all the faded variations we could previously see of the colours above are now completely gone. Now let's look at the flip scenario where you're feeding video data levels from Resolve, but your display is expecting full levels. What happens then is your display shows a compressed image with lifted blacks and reduced whites. And as a result, the calibration image is going to look flat, with noticeably lifted blacks and compressed whites. How to change the data levels of a file if there is a mismatch.
If you remember, at the beginning of the video, we said that you can come across the data level setting in three places.
We've already covered the delivery page and the video monitoring section, but what about the clip attributes in your media pool? Normally, you shouldn't touch this setting, but there are exceptions to the rule.
Often, when you work with VFX and graphics exported from different software such as After Effects or Nuke, the files may appear differently in Resolve. Here is a scenario to consider.
If I export this animated graphic from After Effects, and an export setting that I really like to use is QuickTime RGB plus Alpha for transparency and video codec set to animation. This is an uncompressed codec, so it makes sense to choose it if you want to retain all the information you have. But when I import this in Resolve, I'm going to see a gamma shift. The preview is much more contrasty and the black levels are crushed. So what I can do in my media pool is go to clip attributes and I'll start toggling between the different data levels and see if that fixes it. Setting this to video doesn't solve the issue. But if I select full data levels for this clip, Resolve now interprets the luminance correctly and the graphic now matches what I created in After Effects.
There is so much more to be said about data levels and I've linked to all of the resources I used in my research. And I do encourage you to go down deeper into the rabbit hole if this topic interests you. And this wraps it up for today. Thank you so much if you stuck around until the end. If you learned something new, please like, consider subscribing to the channel, and I'll see you in the next one.